नमस्कार, आई एम आनंद एंड यू आर वॉचिंग जैन फॉर एडुकेशन। लेट्स स्टडी अबाउट परमुटेशन एंड कम्बिनेशन। दिस क्लास विल बी यूजफुल टू द स्कूलिंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11 हैविंग ए सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, एज वेल एज दिस क्लास विल बी यूजफुल टू द एस्पिरेंट्स ऑफ जी मैन एंड एडवांस। Together with this class will be useful to the audience who are interested in mathematics. Let's start the class. Let's see the introduction of permutation and combination. Suppose you have a suitcase with a number lock. The number lock has four wheels, each leveled with 10 digits from 0 to 9. The lock can be opened if four specific digits are arranged in a particular sequence with no repetition. Somehow you have forgotten this specific sequence of digits. You remember only the first digit, which is 7. In order to open the lock, how many sequences of 3 digits you may have to check with? To answer this question, you may immediately start listing all possible arrangements of 9 remaining digits, taken 3 at a time. But this method will be tedious because the number of possible sequences may be large. Here in this chapter, we shall learn some basic counting techniques which will enable us to answer this question without actually listing 3-digit arrangements. In fact, these techniques will be useful in determining the number of different ways of arranging and selecting objects without actually listing them. As a first step, we shall examine a principle which is most fundamental to the learning of these techniques. So this is the simple story which is related to the introduction of permutation and combination. Let's develop the class. Question based upon permutation. Let's see the list. Fundamental principle of counting. Definition on permutation. Permutation, when all the objects are distinct. Factorial notion. Permutation when repetition is allowed. And at last, permutation when all the objects are not distinct. So questions of permutation based upon these 6 subtopics. Questions based upon combination. We have following formula which is used during the solution of exercise problem related to the combination. Permutation of n things when r are taken at a time is equal to combination of n things when r are taken at a time into factorial r. When r greater than 0 and less than or equal to n. This is the second most important formula. Combination of n things when r are taken at a time plus combination of n things when r minus 1 are taken at a time is equal to combination of n plus 1 things when r are taken at a time. These two most important formula is used during the solution of exercise problem of this chapter. Let's see the first question of exercise 7.1. How many three digit numbers can be formed from the digit 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5? Assuming that repetition of the digits is allowed. Second, repetition of the digits is not allowed. This question is taken out from NCERT textbook of exercise 7.1. Let's see the solution of this question. When repetition of the digit is allowed, unit place will be filled by 5 ways. 10 place will be filled by 5 ways. 100 place will be filled by 5 ways. A 3 digit number has 3 place, unit place, tens place and 100 place. So required numbers of 3 digit numbers which be formed from the digit 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 is equal to, this is the 5 ways, this is the 5 ways and this is the 5 ways. So 5 into 5 equal to 125. Hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. Let's see the second part of this question. When repetition of the digits is not allowed, so required number of 3 digit numbers which we form from the digit 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, unit place will be filled by 5 ways. So we have now rest 4 digits. So 10 place by 4 ways and the 100 place by 3 ways. So number of digit will be 60. This is the multiplication of 5 into 4 into 3 equal to 60. Hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. If you have, write into the comment box. I shall try my level best to clear your doubt. Let's see the next question. So this is the next question, or question number 2. How many 3 digit even number can be formed from the digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 if the digit can be repeated? So in a even number, unit digit will be 2 or multiple of 2. So unit digit will be either 2, 4 or 6. Let's see the solution. Unit place will be filled by 3 ways. 10 place will be filled by 6 ways. Repetition of the digit is allowed here, so the 100 place will be also filled by 6 ways. So the required number of 3 digit even numbers which will be formed from the digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is equal to 3 into 6 into 6 equal to 108. Of that, there is no problem to understand the explanation of this solution. Let's see the next question. This is the question number 3. How many 4 letter code can be formed using the first 10 letter of English alphabet if no letter can be repeated? Here repetition is not allowed. Let's see the solution. Required number of 4 letter code which will be formed using the first 10 letters of the English alphabet. If no letter is repeated, will be 10 for first code letter, 9 here repetition is not allowed, and for third code 8, and for fourth code it will be 7. So the multiplication of 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 equal to 5040 or 5040. So this is the explanation of the solution of this question. Let's see the next question. This is the question number 4. How many 5-digit telephone number can be constructed using the digit 0 to 9 if each number start with 6-7 and no digit appears more than 1? So repetition is not allowed here, and 6-7 are fixed. So for 5-digit number, 2 are fixed. So we arrange 3 digit or 3 place of the rest digit of 6-7. So let's see the solution. Here first 2 place will be filled by 1 each, third place will be filled by 8 which, fourth place will be filled by 7 which, and fifth place will be filled by 6 which. So required numbers of telephone numbers equal to 1 into 8 into 7 into 6 equal to 336. So this is the answer of this question, and hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. If you have, write into the comment box. I shall try my level best to clear your doubt. Let's see the next question. This is the question number 5. A coin is tossed 3 times and outcomes are recorded. How many possible outcomes are there? Let's see the solution. In first toss, number of possible outcomes will be 2. In second toss, number of possible outcomes will be 2. In third toss, number of possible outcomes will be 2. So required numbers of possible outcomes when the coin toss 3 times equal to 2 into 2 into 2 equal to 8. So the answer of this question is 8, and hope that there is no problem to understand the solution or explanation of the solution of this question. So hope that this class will be useful to the schooling students of class 11 having a subject mathematics, GMAN and advanced aspirants, as well as the audience who are interested in mathematics. Thank you very much to stay with me in the solution of these 5 questions. My next video lecture will be related to the solution of some more questions of this chapter. Till then, thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.